Mike, you must be really pleased to have a premise like DP World on your patch.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, you can see from the river the scale of the operation and how much business and deployment it could bring to the area. I mean, my only concern is that the jobs that are available at DP World will be going to local people, and that's something I'll be campaigning about quite heavily.
Have you or others approached DP World about that very issue, that there is a possibility that local people may not be employed, or is it great news for the area?
Absolutely. I've been to DP World twice, and I'm going with a group of local residents from East Hilbury at the beginning of December. We must make sure that there's local jobs available for local people. We don't. There's been a lot of unemployment with the closure of Coryton. The area has suffered in the past, and as I say, when you look at the scale of the operation, we need to make sure that the jobs are local, that the infrastructure's there and the transport infrastructure's there, so that local people, South Buzzard and East Thurrock residents, can benefit as the whole country is going to benefit.
You've looked at the infrastructure. Do you think personally that it's good enough?
Well, it's definitely not at the moment. If you live in East Tilbury or know the road running up to Stanford Lee Hope and Corrinham from East Tilbury, there's one level crossing, and when the pool's at full capacity, the crossing is going to be closed for most, if not all, of the night, which is going to cause a real problem for local people trying to get out of the area.
You've been nominated there for several months. You've visited various parts of your constituency. What's impressed you?
Well, it's the people, really. I mean, it's a very big constituency. It's got some great areas in it. It was great to come down to Coal House Fault for the first time when I was first elected, and I've never been down to, you know, that part of the Thames before. That was great. People, it's very industrious. There's a lot of small businesses and people working really hard in the area, but there's a lot of people that need a lot of support, and I'm really keen to make sure that I'm a good constituency MP and make sure that people benefit in the constituency from all the things that are going on.
From those people that have met you, what sort of problems are they giving you at the moment?
Oh, there's lots of things. As I say, I mean, the constituency is sort of split into two halves, really, the Thurrock Authority area and the Basildon Borough Council area. In Basildon, a lot of problems with fires on council estates, real concerns about street lights going out at night soon, and the county council turning off the street lights, which is going to cause a lot of worry and a lot of problems for local people. And in the Thurrock area, it is a lot about transport infrastructure and the roads, and making sure that people are supported. Make sure, as I say, there's lots of local businesses that need a helping hand, and I'm really glad that Labour's going to cut business rates and we're going to freeze the electric and gas bills and make sure that local businesses benefit from that as well.
Mike, thank you very much indeed.
Cheers, Mike.
Polly, we've just been down and spoken to Mike about the exciting new prospect of DP World. But what about the existing port here at Tilbury? What's its future?
What we have to remember is that Thurrock is a river-based community, particularly in our economy. So the DP World should be a great opportunity for all of us. We should be making sure that young people and local people get those jobs in DP World. But inevitably, DP World was conceived when the demand for port capacity was on the up. Since the crash, that's not there anymore, and that makes it very, very difficult, where ports will be competing against each other for contracts. Now, what I worry about is that some of the container contracts here in Tilbury may well go to DP World. But not only that, and that will mean that we won't be expanding, we will simply be competing with each other, but also what that means for people who are working in those ports. Are we going to retain the high standards of terms and conditions? Are we going to retain good health and safety regulations? Are we going to retain the kind of quality of recognition of our workforce? Or are those people going to be at risk with a race to the bottom because big businesses will be fighting each other and trying to undercut each other in order to be able to get the work in their ports. That's my biggest anxiety, that people who work in these in this industry will end up fighting against each other for work in the same way that the ports themselves are fighting against each other for work. And if we don't have decent standards, if we don't have decent regulations, if we don't have decent pay, then that will be bad for all of us.
You've been the nominated Labour PPC for this area for some time now. You've met a lot of constituents, you've met a lot of people. What are their problems? What are they saying to you? What do they want to see changed?
One of the biggest anxieties people have is making ends meet, being sure that they're going to have enough work or the kind of work they want to be able to do, and that their work is secure. They are paid well, that it's secure, and that they have a future for their children, be that a decent job and also a home. So those are the kind of things that happen, that people talk to me about. And actually, when we're talking about Tilbury Docks and we're talking about DP World, those actually have a direct impact on people in Thurrock. When I knock on doors, I speak to people who've lost their jobs at Tilbury Power Station, lost their jobs at Coryton, are worried about whether they're going to be able to get a job at DP World. And all of the time, they're thinking, if I get this job, will it be secure? Will I earn enough money? And are there decent prospects for myself and my children?
Seems very healthy though. I'm not sure whether these containers are coming in or going out, but trade obviously very important to the UK economy. Always a healthy thing though to see exports coming in and out, I suppose.
That's what's really important. If we only see this as an importing place, then we're not really got the kind of economy that we want. If we're talking about an economy where people are building and making things here and we're exporting to the world, then that's definitely something that we can be excited about. But as I say, because the conception of DP World was created before the crash, we've got a problem with the amount of capacity in ports. And that means that we need to be making sure that we do have a growing economy, where we're exporting as well as importing, and that we, as the people who live in Thurrock, benefit from that growth. Now that's what I'm most worried about, because at the moment the growth might be up, but people don't feel that benefit, and they're still very worried that wages are stagnating while prices are going up. And that's just as true for people who work in Tilbury as people who are looking for work in DP World.
Mike and Polly, we've just been out on the river this morning. You've seen both your constituencies from a different angle. Was that a fruitful thing for you to do?
Oh, it was absolutely fabulous. Really, real privilege to be out on the Thames with the Port of London. To find out, you know, what a working river the Thames is. And what we've got to do is make sure that the Thames works for the residents of South Basildon and East Thurrock as well. I'll be going down to DP World next month with some residents from the East Tilbury group that I've been working with, and talking over some of the issues around infrastructure and making sure that people in the area benefit from everything that's going on the river, and also working with Unite to try and make sure that there's recognition for employees and make sure that the people that do work for DP World and the other industries on the Thames are fully supported and get the terms and conditions that they deserve.
Polly, was it good for you as well?
Yes, it was. It was really useful, because we know we are a riverside community with a riverside economy. And when you see how important the river is and how much potential it's got to be able to grow even further in terms of jobs and so forth, it's really exciting. And DP World is a really good example of that. It was conceived as a really big modern container port, but of course it was conceived before the crash. And now capacity in ports across the country is bigger than the amount of demand. So what I'm worried about, a bit like Mike says, is that we don't have a race to the bottom with contracts going from one port to another, and the people who work in those ports having less good terms and conditions, less good health and safety regulations, and less good security and pay. Because if that happens, then actually, even if there is an upturn in growth and an upturn in demand for those ports, people in this community won't benefit. And that's one of the reasons why Mike's right. It is right that people who are working, particularly in the dangerous conditions of a port, have the right of recognition of a trade union.
There was some dreadful survey recently that said Thurrock was one of the worst places in Britain to live. I mean, why has it got that sort of reputation, if that's true at all? What would you say to that survey's result?
I was really disgusted with the way that that was reported, and the suggestion that Thurrock was a bad place to live because people were, that it was seen as it was really miserable. Actually, the people that I meet in Thurrock are extremely determined to make this place a better place, and they're extremely proud of what they do. But the important thing is that we get the benefits that we deserve from the growth in the economy. What happens if, for example, DP World promised that they were going to advertise and recruit locally? We don't know yet where that recruitment and that advertising has actually happened. I think it would be only reasonable for DP World to tell the community how they have recruited, what the outcomes were of that, and how many local people have got the jobs in DP World. Because not only do we have the risk of the race to the bottom, but also that people locally won't benefit from the jobs that are available.
Mike, on your patch, Basildon Hospital's been in special measures recently. I spoke to Eric Pickles, who was confident that things were improving there. What have you seen at Basildon Hospital?
Yeah, I mean, I went to the board of directors meeting the week that Basildon Hospital was put into special measures to talk to Claire Pennicker and see what was actually happening. There was a political attack on Andy Burnham in particular, but the Labour government about Basildon Hospital. What I found was things were actually being put in place to improve conditions at Basildon before the government made that decision to put the hospital into special measures. And I think now they've lifted those restrictions somewhat because things were turning around. There's still issues that need to be addressed, but I think it was a disgraceful attempt to sort of slur the last government when people were really already addressing those issues.
Finally, are you both PPCs for the two different areas? Are you enjoying your time, and are you really looking forward to the election whenever it comes?
Oh, I love campaigning in this community, and I love campaigning with Mike. It's really good to be able to have a good, solid friend who's campaigning on the same kind of issues in a similar community. And the sooner that the people of Thurrock get represented by people who've really got their interests at heart, the better.
Absolutely.